My idea here is let's understand a better way to look at phenomena in the world. Let's understand crime, insurgency, and terrorism better, and not label it as crime, insurgency, and terrorism. But let's blur the line, as you described that that we do with Pablo Escobar. But what can we really do about it? So I have three ideas. First is let's analyze like business executives. So if I'm looking at Al-Qaeda or the Islamic State or the Sinaloa cartel, I'm going to treat them all the same, first of all. I'm going to look at them and I want to know if I were a venture capitalist that was thinking about investing in them, would they be a good investment? Would that firm be worthy of my investment dollars, right? It's strange to think about the Islamic State and the Sinaloa cartel is selling shares and raising money. But I think we should think about it as investors. And do we believe in the business model? So tell me about the leadership structure. Do I think the CEO and the CFO are good, you know, solid people? Do they have a strong mission? Do they have do they have product market fit? Are they selling a product that has elasticity of demand or not? What are their competitors like? Is it a deep market? Do they have massive market share or only a portion of the market share? What's their balance sheet look like? Do they have lots of money in the bank to get them through hard times, or are they just getting by, you know, month to month? How do they recruit? How do they retain? What's their defection constraint? What's their turnover rate? How often, what percentage of their employee base turns over every year? These are really standard business questions that any investor would ask of any potential investment. We should be asking these questions of these firms that we're trying to defeat. These are good, solid questions. Second is we want to define victory in market terms. So when, you know, over the last 15 years, we've been fighting wars in Iraq and Afghanistan. I've been very close in some years, more close in some years than others to this. And I think we got victory wrong. Victory is not, you know, signing a peace treaty and walking away. I don't know that victory ever was that, but it's definitely not that now. Killing the leader, right? Doesn't really bring about victory in market terms. You know, if you're Coke versus Pepsi or you know, IBM versus, you know, Cisco or whatever, you know, you don't think about taking out the leadership. You'd think about taking market share. So once we've done the analysis of these firms, we have to think about us as a rival firm to them, or our allies as rival firms to them, and we want to take market share from them. Taking market share could mean kill the leader, but it doesn't always mean kill the leader, right? Sometimes that is productive. Sometimes that's not productive in the context of violence and warfare. We have to think about how do we win in the marketplace in which this firm operates, in which the Sinaloa cartel and the Islamic State operate? How do we defeat them as a rival firm? So we have to define victory properly.